joining me now to talk about this. So, Jen, on one hand, I wonder what you think, especially as a former top aide to President Obama. You want to juggle multiple priorities, of course, in the White House. And I remember hearing time and again that you can walk and chew gum at the same time from the Obama White House. But you have Harvey still dumping some rain. The flooding really is, we're just in the middle of it there on the Gulf Coast. Should the White House have postponed this pivot to tax reform?
It's a good question. I would say if I were advising them, I would say yes, because the president's focus should be on Harvey. He should be communicating mainly about Harvey. What he's saying this week when Congress is not back is not changing the momentum for tax reform. Congress isn't even in Washington at this point in time.
What do you think, Alice? If Congress isn't here, is this something that he might have been better just waiting a few days, waiting a week or so for?
If he hadn't gone to Texas yesterday, I would say yes, postpone it. But I think his going down to Texas yesterday and showing his support and reiterating the, you know, the federal government is here to help you, that was critical. And reminding them that, look, we have the federal resources, state and local units all working together to get them the help they need. And we're not going away. This is going to be a long effort. But I think it is important to, as we say, walk and chew gum at the same time and push some legislative agenda down the road and continue to get the message out there. It was good to talk about the tax cut and the corporate tax, but also today was a good call to action for people watching, saying, contact your members of Congress. Let them know that you support tax reform, because this is an important agenda for them to get passed.
Alice, the president led his comments, though, talking about the storm in what were empathetic terms from him for really the victims. He's focused a lot, I think, more on the recovery efforts, the response efforts, but he was talking very much on a more compassionate level today because he has had some criticism. Do you think it's warranted?
I think he showed yesterday by being there, he showed that he is committed and compassionate to the people there. Governor Abbott said, I know, having talked with him at length on many of these issues, he's committed to seeing this through. Glenn Thrush in New York Times today said the president is normally one to skim the surface rather than delve into it. He has really delved into what response is being given to the people of Texas and what can we continue to do. And that right there is what the people need. It's not about photo ops. It's not about getting hugs. It's about getting the resources they need to rebuild their lives and get back on track.
Let's talk about his tax plan now. And Austin, you just heard Alice there talking about skimming the surface. I think arguably there could be some bipartisan agreement that that's really what the president did today with his remarks on this. And the short list of details that we do know include reducing the corporate tax rate down from 35% to 15%. When you look at what was sort of a populist tone that he did take, is the plan as you know it in line with the rhetoric?
No, of course not. Look, I would say two things. First, he doesn't have details. The president has made clear he is not in command of the details of tax reform, and he's not going to put them forward. This isn't a pivot. This is literally the fourth time the president has given a major address saying he wants us to have tax reform. It's not a pivot. It's a sit-in spin. And if he's just going to keep stating that he wants to cut taxes by something like $6 trillion, somebody somewhere has got to say how they're going to pay for it. And thus far, no one has done so, and that's why they're stalled out.
Stephen.
Well, you know, I worked with then-candidate Donald Trump in helping put this tax plan together. You know, Austin, he does know the details. He was very specific to Larry Kudlow and I and others who were working on this, exactly what he wanted to do. He always talked about wanting to cut the corporate tax rate because it's just uncompetitive. I think almost all economists agree we can't go forward in a global economy with the highest business tax rate in the world. It's leading to, I just got back from Ireland about a year ago. Every other company is an American company that's moved to Ireland because their tax rate is one-third of what ours is. But he also talked today and whenever I met with him about there's 26.5 million small businesses out there. And he always said, I want to make sure every small business man and woman gets a tax cut too. And Austin, I think his message is very simple. You can't have healthy jobs if you don't have healthy businesses. We want more investment by businesses.
Can I ask you a question about that? Just because you have a lot of economists, Stephen, who have said that this is not going to boost wages. It's not going to boost jobs. So you're saying healthy corporations, healthy jobs, but some economists are saying, look, in the near term, that's not actually what's going to happen.
Well, I mean, look at the history of this. You know, look at what happened under John F. Kennedy when we cut tax rates, under Reagan when we cut tax rates. By the way, I think John F. Kennedy was a Democrat, and he basically talked about how getting tax rates down and giving tax relief to people would create jobs, and boy, did it happen in the 60s and the 80s. So I think there's pretty powerful evidence of that. And look, you just can't go forward. And I think, Austin, maybe you would even agree with this. You know, we're at 40% and the rest of the world's at 20%. I mean, it's just, it leads to companies leaving the United States. We just see this, you know, month after month.
Well, let us return to reality. Okay, the last time the country did this was when George Bush cut taxes for high-income people and big corporations, exactly like Donald Trump is proposing to do now. Let's remember, the GDP growth is fairly strong. The unemployment rate is very low. So how will we increase the growth rate? Well, will it increase to 6%?
Okay. Well, I want to ask, I want to bring Allison in on this.
It's an important question.
Without any pay-fors, that's the root of the problem.
We just had a report that came out today. Hold on. We just had a report that came out today that found that the second quarter GDP growth was 3%, which is a lot higher than we had under Obama, which is 2%. And another report that came out said that so far this quarter, we have 3.5% growth.
So I want to ask, I want to bring Allison on this. And Stephen, you know, after I have Jen respond to this as well, maybe you can weigh into this, because this is a conservative, Ann Coulter, obviously a pundit, responding to this speech, and she said, oh, stop pretending this is about letting families keep more of their money. Half of Americans don't pay taxes. This is for Wall Street. What do you think, Alice?
It's not for Wall Street. And to Austin's point about not being any more details, when Wall Street does well with regard to businesses doing well, America does well. Jobs are created. There are higher paying jobs. And to Austin's point, no specifics. If the president said today we're reducing the corporate tax rate down to 15, that's a pretty powerful statistic and detail of what we're going to do. When America pays a higher corporate tax rate than 35 other major economic countries, then that's a real problem. That sends jobs overseas. We need to become a jobs magnet here and not an outsourcer.
What do you say to that, Jen? I want to give Jen a chance here.
Pretty aligned with Austin. Most of what Alice is saying and Stephen are saying are things that President Obama said in State of the Union addresses. We called for tax reform multiple times. Everybody's for tax reform. It's like bunnies and ice cream. The problem is, how do you get it done and how do you pay for it? And who are the winners and losers? And you can't lower the corporate tax rate to 15% and keep the tax rate at the same rate for middle-income Americans. That's where people are concerned on the Democratic side. That's where many economists are concerned, who will say that that's the way to raise GDP and help people who are struggling.
Well,
I'm going to have to leave it there. We have much more to talk about ahead, you guys, so stand by for me.